Hi, welcome in another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, Microsoft Azure MVP based in Montreal in Canada. And today I want to talk about the environment variable in the Azure Functions and what you can do with it. Aussi, si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de ce vidéo. Cliquez juste ici, en haut à droite. The Azure Functions are really powerful and used in many different situations. But very quickly, to be dynamic, we need to use certain environment variables. So today, I want to show you where to find them and see some little things we can do with it. So here we are in the Azure portal, and we are already in a function app. So to see the environment variables, we go in the platform feature, and here down in the Kudu interface, we'll click that, it will open a new tab. We already see the debug console in a previous video, but for today we'll go in the tab environment. And if we scroll down, here you will have a lot of information about your system, and if you scroll down, here they are, the environment variables. So we have many different things here, like the host name, and the slot name, and the version that is running right now, so we are in version 1 by default. So you will have a lot of information. But how can we use them? Let's go back to the function app. So first, let's create a function. For today, I just need a quick and simple HTTP trigger. So here it is, I won't change anything yet, I will expand the log and the test, and if I just change that for Frank and I run it, as we expect, it will say hello Frank. Perfect. Now we'll add a new section. Okay, perfect. So in this section, I will go get the resource group name and the host name by using the get environment variable, and I will pass the name of the variable. Those names come from exactly here, it's all uppercase. So we'll use that and specify that is for the current process. Then we'll just add a log to trace it. So if I will save it and clean, and now if I run again my function, we'll see here that the resource group is Cloud in 5 minutes and the name, the host name, is exactly that. It worked! Great! Now let's add a little bit more stuff in it. So here I will go get the slot name. Once I got the name, I will check if it's production, and if it's not, I will get out of the function. Otherwise, I will just continue as usual. This could be really useful, for example, if your function is doing some database backup. So when you deploy in staging, you don't want to trigger a backup of your database. So that's a good way to avoid work when you're not in production. Let's save it. Okay, now we need to create a new slot. But the slots are presently in preview and you cannot create them. To activate this feature, you need to go in the function app settings. So here it is, slot preview, and I need to turn it on. We'll take a few seconds. Now that the feature is available, we can create our slot. So we go back here and we'll add a staging slot. Okay, the slot is created. Now we need to do the swap. To do it, we'll go in the tab overview, and here in the top you will see a swap button, so click on that one, it will open a new blade, and then you click again on the swap button. Here you will have many different options, but for today the default value are perfect, so click OK. Now it will take a few seconds to do the swapping, taking the code from the production and swap it to the staging. Swap is completed, now let's go see our functions. So we see now the staging is populated and we have a function here. So we'll click on that. Okay, so we'll expand the test section and the log section. Okay, and we'll just change it for Frankie. And now if I run it, as you can see here, the function result is hello you instead of hello Frankie, meaning that the function did not execute until the end. And we see that the slot name was also found. Right now, if you notice, my code is gray out because the by default, when you swap, it's in read-only, so you don't have conflict when you're swapping. To change this setting, again, it's in function settings, and you could swap here the read-only or read-write functionality. That's it! This is how you use the environment variable. And remember, to get it, you go in the Kudu interface in the environment tab, and there they are. I hope you liked this video and I hope it was useful. Thank you. See you next week.